The lineup of celestial events this month is immaculate, with events ranging from meteor showers, unlikely planetary alignments, and something called a flower moon. If you're a stargazer, then this month of May is the perfect time to pull out your binoculars or telescopes and be ready to hunt in the dark sky. Here we will give you a list of all the events to keep an eye on.
Orbit. Beyond the blue.
Back in 2020, the world saw something called a penumbral lunar eclipse. Since then, not one has graced the sky. To be fair, we've seen a few partial and total lunar eclipses in the meantime, but this month, the penumbral eclipse makes a grand return. You probably have a lot of questions. Like, what the heck is a penumbral eclipse? A penumbral lunar eclipse occurs when the Sun, Earth, and the Moon are imperfectly aligned. When this happens, the Earth blocks some of the Sun's light from directly reaching the Moon's surface and covers or lower part of the Moon with the outer part of its shadow. The penumbral lunar eclipse will dim the Moon ever so slightly at the beginning of May. Unlike the fanfare of a total or partial lunar eclipse, penumbral eclipses are so subtle that they can be easy to miss. The most recent one happened in November 2020. Penumbral eclipses happen when the Moon passes through Earth's faint outermost shadow, called the penumbra. If you are viewing from Africa, Asia, or Australia, the dimming effect will be visible starting at 3:14 PM UTC, and will last for 4 hours and 17 minutes. Europe, North America, and South America will be outside the eclipse's range of visibility. Lunar eclipses always coincide with the full moon. If the eclipse isn't visible in your area, you'll just see the normal full moon glowing in the sky. Jupiter will make a grand comeback. You may have noticed that Jupiter went missing from the sky over the past few weeks. On April 11th, the gas giant entered something called a solar conjunction. This means that the planet was obscured from view as it traversed the far side of the Sun. Since then, Jupiter has slipped past the fiery star and is creeping back into our early morning sky. By May 15th, you should be able to get a clear view of the planet just before sunrise. I don't know about you, but there's just something surreal about being able to see a distant planet with even just our naked eyes. A very humbling experience. And the best part, Jupiter isn't the only planet to make an appearance in Earth's skies. As always, these astronomical events are also loaded with planetary conjunctions that will delight sky lovers. On this occasion, we will see the Moon settle in the sky along with several planets. It will begin on the 13th with Saturn, to continue on the 17th with Jupiter, on the 18th with Mercury, on the 23rd with Venus, and, finally, on the 24th with Mars. And then, the meteor shower. The nights of May 6th and 7th will be the peak of the Eta Aquarius. This is a meteor shower that is above average, with about 60 meteors per hour. Therefore, it would be very easy to see if the sky were not so illuminated by the Moon. Even so, with patience, surely we can enjoy the presence of one of these meteors, coming from the rubble of the Halley Comet. The good part is that it will remain visible until May 28th. For this reason, although with less intensity, we will have more opportunities when the Moon begins to decrease. We know we will be ready with our binoculars and telescopes to witness these events, just to feel something. Will you too? For almost 150 years, when humans have looked at Jupiter, they've seen a raging vortex larger than the Earth itself, swirling with layers of wind and gas. The Great Red Spot, a high-pressure storm that has been brewing on Jupiter for hundreds of years. In 2017, observations by NASA's Juno spacecraft found that the root of the Great Red Spot extends 50 to 100 times deeper than the deepest ocean on Earth, and it has no plans of winding down anytime soon. In the late 1880s, the Great Red Spot measured as wide as 35,000 miles, or around 4 times the diameter of Earth. Then, by the time the Voyager spacecraft made its journey to the gas giant, a century later, the storm appeared to be about twice the width of Earth. This led astronomers to debate whether the Great Red Spot was shrinking in size. In May 2019, an amateur astronomer spotted something unusual about the Great Red Spot. A blade-like shape seemed to be flaking off from the vortex, which led some to believe that it would soon disintegrate into oblivion. So now astronomers have discovered that not only does the storm live on, but its winds are actually picking up speed. What is fueling the Great Red Spot, and how is it maintaining its energy? NASA's Juno probe continues to study the giant planet and map its interior structure while taking stunning photos of the world as well. It can provide us perhaps the best vistas of the storm when aligned just right. Monitoring will also continue by the Hubble Space Telescope and the James Webb Space Telescope, which already took a stunning portrait of Jupiter a couple of months ago. One of the benefits of the James Webb Telescope, or of space telescopes in general, is that they can observe in the infrared part of the spectrum. Because of interference from Earth's atmosphere, our ground-based telescopes cannot achieve this feat. Hence, these Jupiter photos are literally taken in a new light. You can see auroras, or beautiful light shows that appear in the sky. In Jupiter's atmosphere, there are crackling storms, sweeping winds, and unimaginable heights and lows of temperature. To upcoming missions, ESA's Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer JUICE and NASA's Europa Clipper will orbit Jupiter while getting unprecedented views of Jupiter's intriguing moons. In the process, it will get more than a few good glimpses of the Great Red Spot, the largest planet in the solar system. Jupiter has an exceptional gravitational pull, which helps protect the Earth, but this same gravitational force can also cause accidents to happen. An amateur astronomer caught Jupiter in trouble as a large object smacked into the gas giant, creating a small puff. In the planet's atmosphere, yes, accidents happen, even in space. The brief footage shows an object crashing straight into the planet, leaving a small impact behind. Planetary astronomers are not quite sure whether the object is an asteroid or a comet. But don't worry, Jupiter has seen worse. The largest planet in the solar system often attracts this kind of scuffle due to its exceptional gravitational pull, which helps protect the Earth from similar incidents. We do know that it can't have been too big images of Jupiter, since the impact doesn't reveal an impact scar. Although the impact flash looked enormous, it's not a well-known indicator of how big the impact event itself was, said Paul Byrne, an astronomer. The object could have been a few tens to perhaps a few hundreds of meters in size. So this small object probably exploded in Jupiter's upper atmosphere, since it lacked enough size and speed to really pierce through and leave behind a scar. Due to its humongous size and its orbit, which puts it close to the asteroid belt, Jupiter often gets smacked by these objects. The most famous incident took place in 1994, when fragments of the Shoemaker-Levy 9 comet collided with Jupiter. Astronomers believe that Jupiter's sheer massive size actually deflects some of these impacts from the rest of the solar system's planets by taking them on itself. As the largest and most massive planet around the Sun, Jupiter's gravity is so strong that it may actually fling some of these flying space objects outside of the solar system before they get closer to Earth. In fact, some astronomers think that's why life on Earth was able to thrive. Jupiter, then, is like the older kid protecting the underdogs from the bullies on the playground of the solar system, one that takes its share of hits along the way. But what do I know?
Today's video is a quickie, because it's the weekend, and a man's got plans. No, I am not going out or anything. As you know, the heat outside is unbearable, But God help the delusional donkeys, who still believe very strongly that global warming is a hoax. Anyway, I'm just going to lay in my couch, have some ice cream, and watch Family Guy.
Peter, what are you doing?
I'm going out for a spacewalk, Lois. You know, this is our one chance to experience the awe-inspiring wonders of space firsthand.
NASA has recently discovered something that shatters our model of the universe. No, there is nothing to worry about. Since time immemorial, our models of the universe have shattered a lot of times. But this one takes the cake. Astronomers using data from NASA's Transiting Exoplanet Survey satellite and the now retired Spitzer Space Telescope have announced something brand new. A Jupiter-sized planet whirling around a white dwarf star. No, a white dwarf isn't a racist star. They are the very dense leftover cores of once sun-like stars that are now dead. Now, a giant planet candidate, transiting a white dwarf WD1856-53-4, every 1.4 days has been observed. Scientists observed and modeled the periodic dimming of the white dwarf, caused by the planet candidate passing in front of the star in its orbit. The planet candidate is roughly the same size as Jupiter, and is no more than 14 times as massive as its star. Finding a planet still orbiting a white dwarf is exciting, because most planets orbiting a sun-like star would be destroyed when that star first expands into a red giant, before shrinking down to a hot, white remnant core. This planet, somehow, survived that process. The planet, called WD1856b, orbits the white dwarf once every 34 hours. That's 60 times faster than Mercury orbiting the Sun. This system is 80 light years away, in the northern constellation Draco. The white dwarf is about 11,000 miles, 18,000 kilometers across, maybe up to 10 billion years old, and is a distant member of a triple star system. Normally, of course, we think of planets as being much smaller than their stars. But in this case, the planet is orbiting a white dwarf, which is only 40% larger than Earth, so this planet is much larger than the white dwarf it orbits. WD1856b somehow got very close to its white dwarf, and managed to stay in one piece. White dwarf creation process destroys nearby planets, and anything that later gets too close is usually torn apart by the star's immense gravity. I still have a lot of questions about how this planet arrived at its current location without meeting one of those fates. We've known for a long time that after white dwarfs are formed, distant small objects such as asteroids and comets can scatter inward towards these stars. They're usually pulled apart by the white dwarf's strong gravity and turn into a debris disk. Researchers aren't sure how the planet survived and remained intact. The discovery came as something of a surprise. A previous example of a similar system, where an object was seen to pass in front of a white dwarf, showed only a debris field from a disintegrating asteroid. The researchers used Spitzer to observe the system in infrared, just a few months before the space telescope was decommissioned and the mission ended. The age of the system and other data also told the researchers that the object was most likely a planet. Additionally, because we didn't detect any light from the planet itself, even in the infrared, it tells us that the planet is extremely cool, among the coolest we've ever found. Even cooler than Bill Murray, and that's gotta be something in it. Our knowledge about the universe is so little that someday we might even find habitable planets around white dwarfs, but what do I know? It's the weekend, and a man's got plans. Adios?
Wow, neat. So this is space.
Orbit. Beyond the blue.